Hi, I'm Ari Hasiotis, Chief Executive Officer of Cumberland Farms, and I'm here at the Ron Burton Training Village, and I just ran the 7 miles.
How's everybody doing? It's pretty humbling for me to be here with you fine gentlemen. I mean that very sincerely. You know, the things we're able to do for you, the milk and the bread and the juice and all that is great, but it's something I like to do because I'm proud of what you all are doing, and I think that you all have such tremendous opportunity in front of you. So I'm going to share a few things with you that I hope might help you. A very profound moment I had when I was around the same age as a lot of you guys. I was 14 years old. I was in the 8th grade, and I was getting ready to apply to school, to go to a high school that was tough to get into. And I went to see the guidance counselor who was telling me what schools I should be looking at going to. He said, you know, I know you really want to go to this school, it's called St. Mark's, he said, but I'm going to tell you honestly, you're not good enough to go to St. Mark's. It was a huge moment for me. And I left that meeting and I said, this guy doesn't know me at all. I can do anything. 4 years later, I graduated from that school, number one in my class, okay? Now, I tell you guys that only for one reason and not to say, look at me, but to look at what I was. I was an okay student, but think about what I went through. Somebody told me, you can't do it. Someone told me, you're not good enough. And the power of my mind changed that for me and allowed me to take it to a different level. And I call that, everyone, I call that an extreme commitment to self-discipline. You're going to have a lot of roadblocks in your lives. You're going to face obstacles. You're going to face adversity. But just like you are proving every day when you get up at 4:30 in the morning and you run 7 miles, you can do anything in this world. From those words, you are not good enough, I was able to transform my thinking. I was able to go to Harvard Business School and I was able to run a big company with 9,000 people today and a lot of responsibility, all from those words, you are not good enough. So I want to share a couple of things I'm for in closing with you guys. One, I'm for humility, as you've been taught here at the Ron Burton Training Village. Being humble, always knowing and recognizing the need to support others and serve others well. I'm for strength and that self-strength and courage to do whatever it takes to be successful in your lives. I'm for being your best and never, ever, ever letting anyone put limits on you. And most importantly, I want you to recognize that winning has more to do with having the will to prepare to win than just having the will to win. So I want you to think about that. Now, I didn't invent that line. That was a very famous football coach named Paul Bear Bryant. It means everybody has the desire to win, right? There isn't a person that you know that doesn't want to be a champion, that doesn't want to be great. But there's so many people who say that, but they don't have the will to prepare to be great, to prepare to be successful. And that will to prepare to win, you are showing through your early mornings and running 7 miles and all the work and commitment that has you here trying to become as good as you can possibly be. That is the will to prepare to win. The will to prepare to win means you fail at times. It means you stumble. It means you disappoint yourself. It means you disappoint others. It means sometimes you're going to come up short no matter how much effort you put in. But the will to prepare to win will absolutely, ultimately allow you to win in your life. So ask yourself the question, am I prepared to win? Do I have the willingness to do what it takes? You will be successful. You got it. Thank you.
I learned a huge thing about grit and dedication and how when someone tries to tell you no, you tell them, no, if I want to pursue this, then I'm going to go get it. I really learned, like, he really inspired me how to push myself and just push myself through adversity.
Well, he told us about the value of humility in a leader, and what was really, what seemed like the most important to me was the value of commitment towards success.
From the moment I drove in, from the moment we started the run, the thought that went into putting all this together to create this kind of an environment for these young men, I'm inspired. And I'm inspired by the values and you know, the kind of continuous focus on love, peace, patience, and humility, and just how much that resonates for me in my own life. The amount of self-discipline that they can develop through here, it's really awe-inspiring. When you look at what happens in a place like this and the contribution that the Ron Burton Training Village is making to these young people, giving them an opportunity to take advantage of what's in their own brains and their own hearts to build a better life for themselves, to be a part of that, to be able to support that kind of an effort, it's just really, that kind of giving, that's an honor.